Have you heard about the new engine from Toyota that's about to revolutionize the world? No more gasoline, endless expenses, or environmental harm. No joke, soon we'll be driving on water. And no, this isn't some distant project or dream of the future. Toyota has already released a car. Which one and how much does it cost? I'll tell you at the end. So, what happened? We're talking about the development and testing of an eco-friendly engine that runs on water. This technology could radically change the entire automotive industry, so we should prepare for a new era in car manufacturing. It's no secret that Toyota has been toying with the idea of a water engine for a long time, and it seems this one promises to be the most environmentally safe engine ever created. The new unit will be similar to hydrogen fuel cell technology, like the Toyota Mirai, which I'll discuss at the end, as well as hydrogen internal combustion engines, such as the recently developed 3-cylinder 1.6 hydrogen engine. The whole story with water engines is one of the most cherished goals in the automotive industry, as they promise significant advantages over traditional engines and electric vehicles. Many attempts have been made to create functional and reliable water engines for everyday use, but most have not been successful. Now, Toyota is poised to make a breakthrough with their latest water engine. Unlike most previous attempts, which were conducted in makeshift conditions with limited budgets, Toyota has enough resources to test the engine in all possible conditions. Essentially, it's similar to a hydrogen generator, but with some minor differences that make it more suitable for daily use in cars. The engine is very similar to the hydrogen engine used in the Toyota Yaris GRX2, except that instead of using pre-processed hydrogen, the engine produces it itself by separating hydrogen from oxygen through a chemical reaction. The engine uses the process of electrolysis to split H2O molecules. Hydrogen and oxygen are separated when electrodes in a water tank release high voltage. Since hydrogen is already contained in water, there's no need for heavy and extremely reinforced tanks, which are standard for hydrogen fuel cells and hydrogen internal combustion engines, as hydrogen is very difficult to contain. The process of powering the vehicle begins after this stage, similar to the process in hydrogen engines. When hydrogen is separated from oxygen in the new Toyota engine, it is then directed into the engine, where it burns similarly to compressed natural gas. It is important to note that the design features of such an engine are similar to CNG engines. However, to adapt to the characteristics of working with hydrogen, which is a highly energetic and flammable fuel, special fuel injectors for compressed gas are needed. Reinforced cylinder heads, pistons, and valves are also required to withstand the high pressures and temperatures during hydrogen combustion, preventing the risk of detonation. However, there are pitfalls, which I'll discuss later. What about environmental friendliness? Will we be able to get rid of smog in large cities? Firstly, such an engine has almost no carbon dioxide emissions, putting it on par with electric vehicles in terms of environmental cleanliness, but with the added advantage of convenience. The water engine offers the unique convenience of refueling, as it only needs regular water to operate, greatly simplifying the refueling process and reducing costs. A long-term transition to water engines could have a significant impact on the oil industry and mining. If this type of engine becomes widespread, it will reduce the need for oil extraction, which in turn will reduce the environmental damage associated with this industry. Moreover, there will be no need to extract rare metals for batteries, as required for electric vehicles, which is one of the most harmful processes in the modern automotive industry due to its environmental impact. Comparing water engines with hydrogen and fuel cell engines, which are also touted as zero emission, one can see significant advantages of water engines. Storing water is much simpler and safer, unlike hydrogen, which requires special storage conditions, including high safety standards and significant financial costs due to the need for reinforced and reliably insulated tanks. This complexity is due to the high risk of hydrogen leaks, which can lead to explosions or other dangerous situations. In contrast, storing water only requires any airtight container, making the technology more accessible and safer for widespread use. However, a car with a water engine also faces some challenges, as it requires ideal temperature conditions, similar to some other types of engines. But the cost of maintaining such conditions can be high. Nevertheless, distilled water can be purchased at any well-stocked supermarket, or even produced on your own, if you're familiar with basic chemistry. Obtaining pure hydrogen is an expensive process, and along with the numerous problems associated with storing this gas, it's one of the reasons why hydrogen cars have not become widespread and likely never will. The production and storage of hydrogen are expensive, which in turn increases the cost of gas for the consumer, making people wonder why they should buy hydrogen cars if they end up being more expensive to purchase and operate compared to electric and fossil fuel cars. Even though hydrogen cars are theoretically simple to use and eco-friendly, the question remains whether water engines are really suitable for everyday use. The answer is yes. Firstly, these engines are not as weak as they might seem. A water engine is comparable to most gasoline engines in performance, and theoretically could be even more powerful than traditional internal combustion engines, since it can generate 3 times more megajoules of energy compared to gasoline engines. Moreover, these engines are safer than all other types, since there are no flammable substances stored in the car, eliminating the risk of fire or explosion. Water engines are also relatively easy to manufacture, as their mechanical design is only slightly more complex than that of regular gasoline engines, and they are significantly simpler and cheaper to produce compared to electric vehicles and fuel cells. Thanks to their simplicity and cost-effectiveness, such engines are ideal for countries that do not have a developed oil extraction industry. For example, Iranian scientist Aladdin Qassemi managed to adapt his Peugeot 405 to run on water, turning it into a true technological marvel. If one person could create a functioning water-powered car in a garage, imagine what Toyota could do with proper funding. Furthermore, the efficiency of water engines is incomparable. According to Qassemi, his Peugeot 405 consumed 30 to 40 miles per gallon of water, significantly exceeding the performance of a standard gasoline engine. This means that water engines could offer over 80 miles per gallon, substantially reducing the operating costs of the car. But why haven't these engines taken over the world yet? Despite the potential advantages of water engines, the practical implementation of this technology faces serious obstacles. First and foremost, there are logistical problems. Although in theory, maintaining such infrastructure doesn't require significant changes, the engine technology itself is still experimental. Most water engine prototypes created so far demonstrate low reliability, with their functionality and everyday use rated as average or even below average. Using water as fuel may seem like a promising solution at first glance, but the process of splitting water into hydrogen and oxygen poses a number of safety issues. Hydrogen, despite its eco-friendliness as a fuel, represents a high risk due to storage difficulties. Storing hydrogen requires special conditions, as even the slightest leak can lead to serious consequences, including the possibility of explosions. Additional challenges arise from potential resistance from large corporations. If Toyota or any other company begins mass production of water-powered cars, it could threaten the interests of companies involved in lithium extraction, battery production, and most significantly, oil companies. These sectors could lose a significant portion of their business if water engines become the norm, since this would almost completely eliminate the need for fossil fuels and the extraction of costly elements like cobalt and lithium. Such a shift could severely impact even giants like Rio Tinto, who would undoubtedly take steps to counter the development of such technologies. There are already examples of similar incidents in history, such as the case of Stanley Allen Meyer, who created the first fully functioning water-powered car. According to him and his brother, he faced threats from representatives of oil companies. These threats were apparently aimed at stopping his research and developments. Meyer was even offered millions of dollars to destroy his prototype and abandon his research, indicating the potential readiness of large corporations to take drastic measures to protect their interests. However, Stanley Meyer was a stubborn man and did not shy away from publicly fighting against large oil conglomerates. One evening, while having dinner with two Belgian businessmen who showed interest in his work, Meyer suddenly ran out of the restaurant, clutching his throat. His brother, who was with him at the time, followed him. Later, his brother told the press that Stanley claimed the businessman had poisoned him, after which he died. Official records indicate that the cause of death was a brain aneurysm, But this issue remains a topic of debate, as just a few days after his tragic death, the car and engine blueprints were stolen from his garage and were never found. So, while we'd love to see Toyota actually bring this water engine project to fruition, we're not sure it will happen anytime soon, if ever. And even if they are indeed working on this engine, they are likely doing so in absolute secrecy, so there are no official confirmations of the project yet. Crazy, right? Before I tell you about the ultimate hydrogen car, let's summarize the main pros and cons of water and hydrogen engines. As you understand, they are essentially the same thing in the end. In a water car, hydrogen is synthesized within the vehicle itself. One of the main advantages of hydrogen engines is their environmental cleanliness. Hydrogen cars emit only water vapor, making them exceptionally clean. They do not produce carbon dioxide or other harmful emissions, which is crucial in combating global warming. Another advantage is their high efficiency. Hydrogen fuel cells are more efficient than traditional internal combustion engines. They provide greater range on a single fill-up and can be refueled in a few minutes, comparable to refueling gasoline cars, and with water, it would be even easier. However, hydrogen engines also have drawbacks. Firstly, the high cost. Buying a hydrogen car and the hydrogen itself is significantly more expensive than gasoline or electric cars, making them less accessible to the general public. Secondly, limited infrastructure. The network of hydrogen refueling stations is currently limited, making the use of hydrogen cars inconvenient in many regions. Thirdly, storage and transportation challenges. Hydrogen requires specialized and costly storage and transportation systems, as it needs to be stored under high pressure or in liquid form. Additionally, many current methods of hydrogen production are based on fossil fuels, reducing the potential environmental benefits of such vehicles. And while synthesizing hydrogen inside the car might seem to address all these issues, in practice you can't just refuel from a puddle, so there will still be similar nuances. Nevertheless, hydrogen and water engines remain a promising technology with the potential to drastically reduce air pollution levels if economic and infrastructural barriers can be overcome. So, are there any cars already? Yes. Toyota is conducting tests with the Mirai. It's not just a car, it's a glimpse into the future of hydrogen technologies. While the water version hasn't hit the market yet, you can order the hydrogen version for a modest $50,000. Not bad, right? The Mirai's design sparks much discussion with its floating roof, layered hood, and wavy sides, which look unusual and innovative. But the main focus on this car is not because of its appearance. Unlike the Toyota Prius, which has already gained widespread popularity and has hundreds of thousands of buyers waiting, the Mirai currently serves as the launch vehicle for promoting the idea of using hydrogen technologies. The Mirai offers decent dynamic characteristics. 247 pound-feet of torque and 155 horsepower allow it to accelerate to 60 mpuh in 9.6 seconds, which is a second faster than the Prius. Overall, these cars have a lot in common. The Mirai's interior resembles that of the Prius, especially the layout of instruments and controls. However, there are differences, such as quieter operation. The hydrogen generator under the seat emits barely noticeable sounds. The hydrogen version is heavier, which is felt in the turns and the overall softness of the suspension, partly due to the additional weight. Toyota has focused on integrating modern technologies, as evidenced by the Mirai's touchscreen console with a separate climate display while retaining the convenience of familiar controls. This harmony of new and familiar elements emphasizes that the Mirai is a bridge between today and tomorrow, when hydrogen technologies might become the cornerstone of the automotive industry. I believe the future is just around the corner, and not even cartel oil conspiracies can stop progress. If you're interested in new technologies, know how to write scripts, edit videos, or voice recordings, contact us via our Telegram bot at the link in the description. We'd be happy to collaborate. Thank you.